Okay, all you need for this is a couple of balloons and a tea light candle. And I've got both balloons here, I've blown them both up, but this one, and you probably won't be able to see it, the blue one, actually has some water in it. So before blowing it up, I sort of pretty much almost filled the balloon as it was when it's deflated up with water, and then blew it up. So there's a bit of water that's sitting at the bottom, and this one's just a normal balloon. If you hold the balloon over the candle, if I show you the one with the water first, so this has the water just sitting in the bottom there, and hold it over the candle, you'll see that it doesn't pop. Okay? Even though it's been over there quite a long time, it's very hot, it hasn't popped. It's barely even warm, to be honest, on the bottom there. Hold this one over, and you'll see that very quickly it pops like that. So, what's going on? Well, it's all to do with thermal energy transfers. Thermal energy is transferring into the balloon, but it's going into the water, and it's heating up that water. So a huge amount of that thermal energy is going into heating up the water rather than burning the actual balloon. So essentially that water will get warmer and warmer and warmer before the balloon actually pops, unlike the other one where there's nothing else to heat up other than the plastic of the balloon. Again, not really too many safety precautions with this. If you do go too much, it will eventually pop, and you're going to get water everywhere, so just bear that in mind. Also, some students are scared of balloons, so just check with the students before you actually pop a balloon. It can really scare some students.